Benjamin of the Press. On behalf of the Honourable Minister, I have the privilege and honour of welcoming you all to this important occasion. This occasion, you are all aware, is yet another initiative of the Honourable Minister to drive science and technology as a platform to move Nigeria from resource-based economy to knowledge-based economy. So at this juncture, may we all rise, with due respect, may we all rise for the opening prayer. I will start from our distinguished Amazon, our own permanent secretary. This is my our camera.
His Excellency Dr. Funai Onu, the permanent secretary, Elema Wakama, supervising director of the ministry, deputy directors here present, head of units, members of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Good morning, Your Excellency. I wish to crave your indulgence and take you down memory lane. As the first civilian governor of the Abia State, now split into Abia and Ebonyi states, you came up with the concept of village technology. I believe what you had in mind then was how Nigeria could quicken her technological advancement within a short road and catch up with the developed world. You decided to actualize the concept with ABBA. Unfortunately, the military took over did not allow you to achieve this. Also said, shortly after being appointed and sworn in as the Honorable Minister of Science and Technology, in November 2015, a reception was organized in your honor by some well-wishers at the Transcorp Hilton Hotel here in Abuja. You made a pledge to take Nigeria's science, technology, and innovation to the next level. No wonder, sir, within a short period, you have come up with the annual Techno Expo, the Science, Technology, and Innovation Roadmap 2017 to 2030, the National Strategic for Competitiveness in Raw Materials and Product Development in Nigeria, a prototype, Your Excellency, the Bioresource Department of this ministry, is this morning making a presentation on stimulating the private sector, both local and international, in participating in the acceleration and upscaling Nigeria's science, technology, and innovation system. This is in order to bring about rapid technological development in the country. You have always said that no country in this world has attained greatness without science, technology, and innovation. Recently said, there has been an increase in global private sector participation in driving the development of science, technology, and innovation, and also making the benefit accessible by society. However, as with other sectors, the major impediment to private sector participation is the deficit in infrastructure support and facilities in the country. You may wish to note, sir, that some of the agencies and parastatals under your ministry have infrastructural facilities that may be leveraged upon to promote and enhance private sector participation in research and development and commercialization of its outcomes. Consequently, sir, the Department of Bioresource Technology of the Ministry wishes to propose the establishment of a reference biotechnology center of international standard in NAMDA. This center will be involved in conducting clinical examinations through laboratory medicine and imaging techniques, conducting R&D into rapid enzyme-linked immunosorbent acid medical diagnostic test devices, biologics, biopharmaceuticals, and vaccines, as well as setting up production facilities for them. It is an indisputable fact that biotechnology is a critical propelling force backing current global science and technology development, and bioindustry has become a center of attention of international competition. Many countries have developed national strategies, formulated policies, and substantially increased investment in biotechnology, subsequently making it a deliberate priority in global competition. Biotechnology assumes significant strategic importance in addressing major issues facing the world, such as population growth, health, food security, sustainable energy, and environmental protection. Your Excellency, sir, you are aware that due to the dwindling budgetary allocation over the years, NAMDA has not been able to accelerate her development agenda, which should be in tandem with Nigeria's aspirations, particularly the provision of state-of-the-art laboratories, nationally driven R&D programs, just to mention a few. During your maiden visit to NAMDA in 2016, you give the management team a marching order that NAMDA should develop vaccines for Ebola, Lassa fever, Zika, particularly the hemorrhagic viral diseases ravaging the West African region then. Sir, the establishment of a reference biotechnology center of international standard at NAMDA can be achieved by the invitation of potential investors with deep interest in biotechnology to lease for land at NAMDA through expression of interest using the Public Procurement Act as a platform for a competitive process through an advertisement for interested companies or private sector investors to pitch. Thank you, Your Excellency.
Most duly observed, we have listened to the moving speech of Pharmacist Sogotale. In fact, I won't say this is just a speech. It is like it's a clarion call to action based on the directive of the Honorable Minister. At this juncture, may I kindly invite the Honorable Minister to please respond, to give his opening remarks. Honorable Minister, sir.
Our permanent secretary, supervising directors, members of the press, most distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I would like to start by apologizing for our starting late. You know, we keep to time, so I don't want you to think this is the new way to make sure that it doesn't happen again. Keep to time. I would like to thank the director for what he has said and the work that this department is doing. We are very interested in changing the direction that our country is taking because we are very concerned about so many things that we believe that with proper deployment of science and technology, we can help solve those problems for our country. We are concerned with job creation. We are concerned with wealth creation. We are concerned with poverty reduction. We want a situation where our citizens can be prosperous and happy. And then our country will be rich and strong. We believe this can be realized. Many countries that used science and technology effectively have achieved this. And that is what we are working very hard to achieve in the country. But government cannot do it alone. All Nigerians must work together for us to take our country to this level, which all of us desire. And I believe that Nigeria will achieve. It does not matter the difficulties or the challenges on the way, but we are going to get there. This requires that government, the organized private sector, all citizens of Nigeria will work together. And we have been trying to promote a very warm relationship between research institutes, not just those in the Federal Ministry of Science and Technology, but in other ministries and even in industry. That relationship, to strengthen it with the organized private sector, with industry, with business, with even the informal sector, because we believe that every segment of society can make very important contribution in our helping us to deploy science and technology effectively in the development of our country. Please, the level of research and innovation that is going on in the country, both within government and outside government, in industry, in our universities, our polytechnics, because we think and we believe very strongly that this is what we need as a country to go to where we want to be. So I would like to use this opportunity to again call on our investors, Nigerian investors, our entrepreneurs, you know, to really work very closely with our research institutes, because this is a win-win situation whereby the profit margin will even improve. They will make more money using the research that we are doing and we have done. And also, whatever that is needed to make sure that that relationship is strengthened, we are going to do so. We will look at what you are proposing today and see how that can also be incorporated. But there are so many other areas that this we can use to strengthen this relationship between the research institutes and the organized private sector. And we are very hopeful that our country will get to the level where our gross domestic product will be many times what it is today. And above all, to ensure that Nigeria will attain self-reliance, because we just can't continue to be importing all the things we need. So this reference about technology center, which definitely will be of international standard, is welcome and is something that we will need to make sure that some of the tests that we do outside the country can be done here in Nigeria. And this will help us to conserve our foreign exchange. It will help us to further strengthen our Naira and also help us in creating jobs. Department for the work that
you
are doing. Thank you so much.
Honorable Minister, he said that every great feat begins with every great idea, or every great feat begins with an idea. And this is a veritable milestone in the honors of the history of this ministry, that an initiative Minister, have another round of applause. On this note, I think we have come to the end of this session. So I think we should all rise for a photograph with the honorable president.